Hi, this is Dr. Don, and I have part two of the pivot table overview videos. This is the original data that we used to create the pivot table that I'm going to show you how to make. When you are trying to use a pivot table, you need to check your data to make sure it is ranged as a table. And by that I mean the first row in your data set needs to contain labels, titles of each of the columns. And you may recall that we sometimes call these columns as if they contain variables or data fields. And again, you need to have that first row only consist of titles. Then there needs to be one row for each item that you're interested in. In this case, we have employees, and for each employee, all the data that we need for this each employee is in that one row. If you had data scattered among rows, then the pivot table couldn't find them properly. So make sure you have one row, one record per item. Then you need to make sure there's no empty rows in your data set. You can make do with an empty cell here and there. Excel can work around that as long as it's not an entire row or an entire column that's empty. So if you have those, scan your data, find them, and delete those empty rows, and then delete those empty columns. Finally, you need to make sure there's no extraneous information on the edges of your data. For example, here in this table, I've got a little note that I gave myself. Check on this salary. Now, what you can do is delete it, or you can just move it so it's no longer touching, so it's no longer adjacent, and that should be okay. Now, down at the bottom, I think I recall that I put a total. So I'm going to use the shortcut, Control Shift Down Arrow, to go down to the very bottom of the data table. And there you can see, yes, there's 9,230 records there. And I'm going to get rid of these two cells there that had the total. And I'm going to go back up to top, Control Shift Up Arrow, and that puts me up at the top. To create the pivot table, all you need to do is click somewhere in your table and then go up to the Insert ribbon, click on that, find Pivot Table, and click on that. Now, you'll see there's a recommended pivot table there. That can be a shortcut if you know what you're doing. Excel will look at your data and try to suggest how you should create your pivot table. But sometimes that can start you off in the wrong direction. So I like folks, particularly in the learning, to start with a basic pivot table, click on that, and you get this dialog box. And it will tell you, we've selected this range, all of the cells that are adjacent, and it goes from A1 to K9229, which is what I want. I don't want to use an external data source. And as I go down, I want to put my pivot table on a new worksheet. Generally, that's better if you use a new worksheet than trying to use put it on your original data. And then finally, just for your information, note you can use more than one data table, more than one worksheet, and create what they call a data model, which is just a pivot table with multiple worksheets. We don't want that. We want just a simple, so I'm going to click OK. Excel inserted this new worksheet. Here it's labeled it Sheet 14 because Sheet 14. I've made a lot of worksheets before I made this video. And it's blank, except there's some information there. It says, here's where you build your report, and you do it by pulling fields from the pivot table field list, which is over here on the right side. And here's a list of the fields or the variables we have in our data table. And you build your pivot table by dragging these fields into this area at the bottom. And that will be the subject of the next video. So tune in shortly and we'll build that table that we use to create the report.